Space music from Spaceland on KMSC. Now, a word from J Marks.
Mr. Chairman, delegates, my fellow Americans, to satisfy your need in trucks, it is my honor to put into nomination J Marks Chevrolet. They specialize in immediate delivery, special savings on the fleet side long bed pickup. That's at J. Mark Chevrolet in La Porte by the Bay.
Extended range, smooth running, long wearing with fine wide range fidelity. And if you're just getting started with your first cassette recorder, the Smart Buy is Highlander because it means economy plus performance, low priced, but still made by 3M Company, the people who pioneered magnetic recording. Next time you need cassettes, remember Scotch brand. Whatever kind of recording you do, there's a Scotch cassette that gives you the most for your money. Now, if we could only find a cassette Scotch.
This is Jeremy Stieg on Jazz with Alan. 26 minutes after 4 o'clock on a Saturday morning.
Luxurious studios in beautiful Nassau Bay. This is KMSC Stereo, Clear Lake City, at 102.1 FM, overlooking NASA's Manned Spacecraft Center, control point of man's greatest adventure. KMSC. Thank you.
from the authoritative news voice of Spaceland, award-winning KMSC Capsule News.
Good morning, it's 4:30, and here is the latest news on KMSC. South Vietnamese troops, backed up by U.S. tanks and armored personnel carriers, have killed 215 North Vietnamese in heavy fighting inside the demilitarized zone. Another 90 communists were also reported killed in a series of clashes just south of the DMZ. In Washington, former President Dwight Eisenhower suffered his seventh heart attack Friday afternoon. The doctors at Walter Reed Army Hospital described his condition as stable. The 77-year-old general has suffered four such serious attacks since May. The United Nations 15-member Security Council has passed a resolution condemning Israel for its fourth air raid against Jordan. The resolution, however, did not specially mention the Arab commando raid into Israel, which triggered the air attack. This is the latest political news. Georgia Governor Lester Maddox jumped into the contest for Democratic presidential nomination, in his words, to save the party from socialism. He'll make a formal announcement Saturday on a national broadcast at 11 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. In Chicago, Democratic Party officials said there would be no floor demonstrations for candidates at the national convention. They're also considering allowing candidates to address the convention before the voting. In San Diego, Richard Nixon conferred with Governor Ronald Reagan. They announced that Reagan would do limited national campaigning for Nixon with emphasis on television. In Minneapolis, Hubert Humphrey called the Republican Party the Nixocrats and said they offered the usual platform on empty promises. In Washington, Senator Eugene McCarthy predicted the battle over the seating of a Georgia delegation will be the critical test of the Democratic convention. McCarthy said he may stage a floor fight to oust the delegation led by Governor Maddox. In Detroit, Senator George McGovern said he was seeking former Kennedy delegates and would go into the Democratic convention with about 200. In Hammond, Indiana, third-party candidate George Wallace told a crowd of 5,000 he would lower the working man's taxes and remove tax exemption from multi-billion dollar foundations. He predicted that he would win the electoral vote of Illinois and Indiana. In Hollywood, the two-year marriage between Frank Sinatra and Mia Farrow ended Friday when a Mexican court granted a divorce to the 23-year-old actress. The couple has been separated since November, and Ms. Farrow sued for the divorce on grounds of incompatibility. If it's jazz, and it's happening, it's on KMSC.
Thank you.
pile up credits for your future, stack them in the form of United States savings bonds. Bonds are better than ever, now paying 4.25% when held to maturity. And when you buy bonds, either over the counter or at your bank, or through the automatic payroll savings or bond-a-month plans, buy the new 5% Freedom Shares in combination. Credit your future and Uncle Sam's, too, with higher-paying savings bonds and Freedom Shares. You know, I recently heard that they've started selling savings bonds to the Russians, and in the first day, over 75% of them were gone. So be sure and get your bonds now before all the red commies get them. Back to music from Masakela.
At this time, we'd like to play a little reprise from England that was done by a group called the Procol Harum, and they call it The Whiter Shade of Pale.
Back to jazz after this important word from J. Mark Chevrolet.
Mr. Chairman, delegates, my fellow Americans, what this country needs is a good deal on a new Chevrolet, the car that has more of the good things you buy a new car for. It is my pleasure to put into nomination J. Mark Chevrolet in the port by the bay.
Don't forget to send in your heavy poetry to Alan on KMSC. New gig is I'm going to be reading some of your grooviest stuff so we can share it with everybody. Nothing sounds better than a little poetry over some jazz. Anyway, this is the Action Album of the Hour, and that's Action with Jackie McLean. It's now 13 minutes before 5 o'clock, and I wish you'd get up since I'm up, so here's music.
With extra dimension stereo music, this is KMSC Stereo, found only at 102.1 FM, Clear Lake City, Texas, serving the entire metropolitan Bay Area from studios adjacent to NASA's Manned Spacecraft Center, KMSC. Portions of KMSC's programming are delayed and brought to you by mechanical reproduction.
At 102.1, your dial is tuned to the KMSC Weather Beam.
At 5 o'clock, this is the latest weather from KMSC. Thunder showers and storms border Texas this evening with heavy clouds in the northwest and along the Gulf Coast. It was a hot and sticky temperature day for most of the state yesterday, and brisk southerly winds ranging from 10 to 20 miles an hour carried moisture-laden air to the north to keep temperatures across the state in the below 100-degree mark. The forecast for the weekend is for more warm weather with readings in the high 90s. The northwest will have a shower or two, and showers will also fall along the coast. The weather for southeastern Texas, including the KMSC listening area, will be partly cloudy and warm Saturday through Sunday, with scattered mostly daytime showers and thunder showers. High is Saturday 88 to 96, lowest Saturday night 74 to 84. Right now at KMSC, it's 80 degrees, it's 79 downtown and 79 at the airport. It's a great day to go to the beach, and the surf is up.
Stereo KMSC weather.
Moonsong from Roland Kirk on Jazz with Alan.
Thank you.
Don't forget about tomorrow. That's when you'll be hearing from my little bitty baby cousin, Bunkin. She's here every morning at 7:15 with her new portion of the Bunny Love Show, Little Bit of Trivia. Whatever she tells you may be trivial, but it's always interesting. That's Bunkin on the Bunny Love Show every Monday through Saturday at 7:15.
Went down to St. James Infirmary. Saw my baby there. Stretched on a long white table. So sweet, so cold, low there. Let her go, God bless her. Wherever she may be, she can search this whole wide world over. She'll never find a sweet daddy like me. When I die, bury me in straight-laced shoes. Box-back coat, Stetson hand. Put a $20 gold piece on my watch chain. So the boys know die standing pat.
With music on Extra Dimension Stereo, KMSC, after this word from J Marks.
Mr. Chairman, delegates, my fellow Americans, the choice of the 1968 Chevrolet convention is J Marks Chevrolet. For new deals on that new Chevrolet you've been wanting, see J. Mark Chevrolet in La Porte by the Bay.
This is Miles Davis, Miles in the Sky. He's psychedelic-sized. Once he's been psychedelicized, you just can't stop him. This is Country, Country Sun.
Thank you.
Country sun, Miles Davis, miles in the sky. It's 25 minutes past 5 in the morning, and it's time for you to get up. And jazz is the best way I know of doing it. This is KMSC, Extra Dimension Stereophonic Music at 102.1. I'm Alan, and I play jazz for 6 long hours during the night, just to give you something to groove to. Picked up a lot of new records lately, so I hope you're listening to those. I'd like to remind you that I'd like to get a hold of all your heavy poetry, so if you're writing down your grooviest thoughts, send them in to me, Alan, at KMSC. We're going to do a little poetry over jazz. Now a word about what's happening in your own backyard.
This is Gene Edwards for Panorama, heading for the border, the Mexican border, where my first bullfight is only an hour away. And leaving behind me a week of international travel without ever leaving Texas, USA. The name of the excitement is Hemisphere 68, a world's fair to end all world's fairs, and a beautiful birthday present from San Antonio, 250 years young this summer, to 7.5 million vacationing Americans. The fair itself is everything a fair ought to be, big enough to represent the world, small enough to say goodbye to sore feet. And the city is really special. As Spanish-accented as a good enchilada, and smack in the middle of some of the most beautiful country on any continent. Plus, a cram course in the cultural history of the Americas, starting with the Aztecs, who were here first, represented by the ritual rain dance at the Frito-Lay Pepsi-Cola Pavilion, and winding up with a good long look at the world of the future. History was never like this back when I was in school, and I'm glad of it. I wouldn't have had the fun of learning San Antonio style if it was, and that's the kind of fun I wouldn't have missed for the world.
Jazz to the third power, the Lee Orlando Trio on KMSC.
overlooking NASA's Manned Spacecraft Center from luxurious studios above the Nassau shops. This is KMSC Stereo, Clear Lake City, at 102.1 FM, sending you extra dimension stereophonic music with the Southwest first full-powered stereo signal.
The authoritative news voice of Spaceland, award-winning KMSC Capsule News.
Good morning. Here's the latest news on KMSC. South Vietnamese troops backed up by U.S. tanks and armored personnel carriers have killed 215 North Vietnamese in heavy fighting inside the demilitarized zone. Another 90 communists were also reported killed in a series of clashes just south of the DMZ. Washington, former President Dwight Eisenhower suffered his seventh heart attack Friday afternoon, but doctors at Walter Reed Army Hospital described his condition as stable. The 77-year-old general has suffered four such serious attacks since May. The United Nations 15-member Security Council has passed a resolution condemning Israel for its fourth air raid against Jordan. The resolution, however, did not especially mention the Arab commando raid into Israel, which triggered the air attack in the first place. This is the latest political developments. Georgia Governor Lester Maddox jumped into the contest for the Democratic presidential nomination, and in his words, to save the party from socialism. He'll make a formal announcement Saturday on a national broadcast at 11 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. In Chicago, Democratic Party officials said there would be no floor demonstrations for candidates at the national convention. They're also considering allowing candidates to address the convention before voting. In San Diego, Richard Nixon conferred with Governor Ronald Reagan. They announced that Reagan would do limited national campaigning for Nixon with emphasis on television. In Minneapolis, Hubert Humphrey called the Republican Party the Nixocrats and said they offer the usual platform on empty promises. In Washington, Senator Eugene McCarthy predicted the battle over the seating of a Georgia delegation will be the critical test of the Democratic convention. McCarthy said he may stage a floor fight to oust the delegation led by Governor Maddox. In Detroit, Senator George McGovern said that he is seeking former Kennedy delegates and would go into the Democratic convention with about 200 votes. In Hammond, Indiana, third-party candidate George Wallace told a crowd of 5,000 that he would lower the working man's taxes and remove tax exemption from multi-billion-dollar foundations. He predicted that he would win the electoral vote of Illinois and Indiana. Czech party boss Alexander Dubček has warned his countrymen not to press for more reforms too fast. His warning came amid reports from the Soviet Union of stepped-up war games in the communist states bordering on Czechoslovakia and Soviet criticism of the Czech free press. In Cape Kennedy, the U.S. displayed its nuclear firepower for the 1970s with two launchings Friday. The Air Force sent up its Minuteman III instant ICBM, while the Navy fired a submarine-based missile. Both tests were successful. And finally, from Hollywood, two-year marriage between Frank Sinatra and Mia Farrow ended Friday when a Mexican court granted a divorce to the 23-year-old actress. The couple has been separated since November, and Ms. Farrow sued for the divorce on grounds of incompatibility. Jazz continues on KMSC. I'm Alan, and this is the Blues Project Projections.